So the final strong oracle I want to talk about is what I'm going to call a null space transformation. And this is where we take a random test case, or any test case, of course, and we make some sort of a change to it that shouldn't affect how it's treated by the software under test. And so one thing we could do, just as a trivial example, is we could start with a simple Python function. This is the input to the null space transformation. So here we have foo of a and b returns the sum of a and b. And one possible null space transformation on this would be to add a level of parentheses, or maybe several. Now, this is a null space transformation because we've transformed the test case, possibly in a non-trivial way, although here we've done something pretty trivial, but we've transformed it in such a way that we know that the meaning of the test case shouldn't have changed. So now we can do something very much like differential testing, but instead of taking the same program and running it through two implementations of Python, we're going to take two programs which are semantically identical and run it through the same implementation of Python. And if that implementation of Python treats this differently, that is to say, it interprets this code in such a way that it returns some different answer, then we found a bug in it. So of course, we could always do things even more elaborate. So here we're calling some sort of an identity function on A, that is to say, some function that is guaranteed to return the same value of A that it's called with, although of course that's not going to be apparent to the interpreter. And then instead of adding B to A, we're going to subtract minus B from A. So another little null space transformation. And I've heard of these kind of things, and so I don't have any personal experience using null space transformations to find bugs, but I've heard of people doing this kind of thing, and apparently it can be useful. So what have we done here? What we've done is seen that in realistic situations, there are a lot of potential oracles available for performing random testing. And so the conventional wisdom, at least as it's expressed in that article or that chapter on random testing, that oracles are almost never available, I think is probably not right. It's often the case that if we think about it for a while, that if we're potentially willing to invest some time in creating a good oracle, then we can very often find something to use for random testing.